right, so I have my infused oil with bacon grease, and I'm going to add some shallots. I threw in butter, obviously. Add some shallots. We're going to start our gravy. It's a kicked up gravy. So throw those in there, get those nice and translucent. I'm constantly stirring this, just get in the habit of doing this. And I'm using a wooden spoon because I don't have a plastic whisk, and that's going to come important for the butter. I might use a whisk a little bit, but I don't want to scratch my pan. But I'm making sure I scrape the bottom of this pan because that's a lot of butter to get the chicken bits worked in there. Alright, so to that we will add just a little small handful of shallots. This is softening up nicely. This is very hot oil. We're going to add garlic. Stir this for about 30 seconds until it's fragrant. I saved about a third of a cup of my seasoned flour from the fried chicken rather than getting new flour, so all that salt, all that seasoning and those herbs, just all together. The one thing I don't like about Cracker Barrel is that sawmill gravy. It just lacks so much flavor. You just added a little bit extra. Okay, so to that, let's add that seasoned flour and just get stirring. And you want this. Cook this down for about 2 minutes. Get that flour taste out. Cook the flour taste out of it. You don't want this to brown, so you want to constantly stir. We're not making a brown gravy, we're making a white gravy. Season this to the end because everything, this flour is seasoned. We're going to add some chicken stock with that salt, so we're not going to season this until the very end. Okay, so to that, we're going to add in some chicken stock. Okay. That's about a quarter of a cup, maybe a third of a cup. Add a little bit more just for your desired thickness. I just want to thin this out a little bit, and I'll add a little bit more in just a minute, and then we'll add some cream. That's good on chicken stock. Okay, so I got most of those little lumps out with the spoon. Now I feel okay with getting my whisk. I'm actually going to use the itty bitty whisk attachment to your blender because these are a little bit smaller, so it won't scrape as much. Alright, so now I brought this heavy cream to room temperature. We're just going to slowly add cream. Switch to the whisk. More cream, go a little more stock. Always keep this for leftovers. Some eggs in the morning. I think that's what I'm gonna do for tomorrow, guys. Just a handful of herbs, some thyme, rosemary, oregano, and some fresh parsley. Come to a small boil, and then our gravy is done, and we'll season right at the end if need be. All right, I'll see you back later.